Hi everyone, Ian Van Tile here, and behind me is a new listing of mine at the Kona Kai Marina here in San Diego, California. It is a 2008 Jeannot 39i. This is a upgraded performance version. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this amazing yacht has to offer.
I want to start at the bow, and here you can see we actually have a double bow roller system. The second bow roller has actually been replaced, but it could be put back in if so desired, with the removable Seldon bow sprit. The bow sprit is actually stowed on the lifeline rails and is easily deployed by clipping into a D-ring up on the deck. This will allow you to fly an asymmetrical spinnaker, code zero, and get it out of the way of this bow sprit that you see here. This is a Mark Lombard design hull. This particular vessel, the 39i, is known for being a very powerful, fast performance cruiser. The reason I say it's a performance cruiser is we actually have an upgraded tall mast, an extended boom, classic mainsail with a hard and back car system on it with upgraded sails, and it is definitely a screamer. This eye in the 39i indicates that the deck itself is injected molded. This is a stronger yet lighter product, really giving the vessel a kind of a cutting edge above other competition that it has. What it's doing again is it's making the deck lighter by, I would say on this particular model, about 500 pounds, bringing that center of gravity down lower, making it stable, and again, at the end of the day, a faster, lighter weight vessel. Beautiful lines that the Sun Odyssey possesses. We have the tow rail with nice opening kind of ports here to allow us to gain access to our cleats. And it also has a nice transom. The transom also has a three-step boarding ladder. Here at the back of the vessel, there's a hot and cold swim step shower. Centrally located is a designated life raft locker that has a lock system on it as well too. Our shore power, our stern light. The vessel also has a radar post here at the back with the Raymarine radar. And as we move up into the cockpit, you can see just how nice this cockpit is. We have a Navtec adjustable backstay. At the starboard side of the helm, we have our throttle controls, our engine controls. We have our autopilot, multi-repeater, and wind point wind speed. Also in front of the helm is the compass, along with the docking station for the VHF RAM mic. There is a manual bilge pump system here. And what's really unique about this particular vessel is it has the removable cockpit table. So with an adjustment down below and a quick pin, this table will actually remove, getting it out of the way of all of your guests. And if you're cruising, be a nice cockpit table here. Over here at the port helm, we have our wind point wind speed, our tri-data, and then also we have our display controller for our base mast repeaters. I don't know if you can see them from here, but I'll walk up here in a second. But that was what this is. All of the sheets and halyards are led aft. We have our main sheet led aft, and then we also have our jib sheet led up to here. And or we can put locking block clutches, and you can adjust both main sheet and jib sheet from right here at the helm, making it really nice. But again, if it depends on if you're cruising it or racing it, this definitely has all of the setup. I'm gonna take you up forward, and as you can see, it's a nice, easy, gradual walkway up forward, nice wide side deck. So we have a nice Dodger system here, stack pack system by Doyle. This is a Seldon mast. We have the Seldon rigid boom vane. Those are our mast base repeaters. One thing I really like is the split stays, so it allows you nice, easy access up to the foredeck. The other thing I wanna point out is it also has diform standing rigging. Biggest thing that you could tell about diform standing rigging is it has the flat edges on it. This is a much stronger, less stretch than your standard rigging, kind of gives you the strength of rod rigging. We have our anchor locker here. This is a quick windlass leading onto a large anchor locker. As I mentioned, the bow roller system here and where the bow sprit clips down into the deck. Looking back aft, we have the pole itself. And then all of the sheets and halyards are led into the cockpit. Again, making this vessel very easy to single hand and shorthand sail. Traveler up on the cabin top. Again, this has the double-ended sheeting, so we have controls from the main sheet at both starboard and port helm. but a beautiful cockpit, nice large voluminous for a vessel of this size. And again, there's two nice large lazarette lockers, both to starboard and port. And then behind the helms, we have our double propane locker here. Again, life raft locker in a large deep lazarette locker here. One thing you're also going to notice is the design of the footrests here. So when you're on a heel, you do have really good footing anywhere you go. There are two speakers here in the cockpit. And as we move up forward, off to the port side, we have a two-speed Harkin electric winch, fast and slow speed. And then again, all of the sheets and halyards are led back here. Now coming down below the vessel, we have the galley off to the starboard side. This is your traditional L-shaped galley, two burner stove and oven, double stainless steel sinks, lots of storage and drawer space throughout. There is a overhead opening hatch above the stove, a nice deep refrigerator with small freezer compartment space there. Again, double stainless steel sinks. Underneath this cabinet is our trash can, additional storage. Directly across from us is our head and shower compartment. So this is a nice use of space here. This is the manual Japsco toilet. We have a molded sink, a vanity, and behind this cabinet door is access to the holding tank itself. Both starboard and port cabins are identical twins. As we move our way back aft, this particular cabin has an upgraded mattress. These are really nice, large beds themselves. They both have double hanging and storage locker system, storage underneath them, and just a great overall feel with a overhead opening hatch and a inboard opening hatch and a fixed outboard port. As we go centrally located now to the engine compartment with two locking switches, this opens right up and you have access into the engine compartment itself. The engine is quite nice. Currently the display is not showing the engine hour gauges, but I think we're assuming it's going to be somewhere in that 600-700 range, but I will try to do my best to confirm that with any records we might have. And then off to this aft starboard side, we have our traditional mattress here with a memory foam topper. We have our battery switches here. This is where the companionway hatch is stowed. It has a really nice wood cleats that this stows into. Again, this is a hanging locker, shelving system, additional shoe storage underneath this hanging locker, the little tongue twister there. And again, nice view looking forward into the large galley and salon. The Sun Odyssey itself has that low profile deck, but also floods the salon with a lot of natural light, great ventilation. Again, lots of storage found throughout underneath all of the seating components as well. We have a nav station here that's convertible. And the reason I say it's convertible is you can actually have it in this position. You see that rail system? It'll slide back. There's a little filler piece that goes here, so it kind of extends it out. But again, there we go. We're adding a little bit of seating. The nav station's out of the way. It could be aft facing if we so desire. But again, it's just kind of versatile, and it's a great use of space. Here, when it's forward facing, there is storage underneath here, additional storage there. We have a 110 outlet. This is our Xantrax inverter controller. We have a new VHF radio, Sony stereo, CD DVD player. This is our 110, our 12 volt size, our tank monitoring gauges. This will allow us to monitor our fuel, our water tank capacities, our batteries from domestic and to engine. And then we also have our GPS plotter here. So we have multiple function displays here. We have our radar, GPS. We have page displays where we can just see the GPS itself, radar, and so on and so on. But again, this is a nice display here. And again, really great use of space. The salon table can be converted down into a berth. There are smaller legs. This can convert down. Again, but great style seating here. Large bench seat off to the port side. We have our television that's wired into the Sony DVD player there. And moving up to the forward V-berth, the master, in my opinion. Great V-berth here. This is a custom mattress. We have a hanging locker off to starboard. Great use of space down through here as you walk in, close the door. Lots of shelving throughout. Overhead opening hatch, which is quite nice. And again, behind the door itself is an additional hanging locker closet. really beautiful teak and holly floors. This teak interior is the LP wood, so zero maintenance whatsoever. And again, this is the ultra leather interior cushions. It really has that look of leather, the feel of leather, but it is super durable. I can tell you, my father-in-law has this, and with my two girls, we've spilled wine, blueberries, it wipes right off. Again, a great use of space and a very low maintenance vessel. Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you would like additional information, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tile, at any time, day or night. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, I would appreciate it if you would subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this. Thank you again. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.